It's Wednesday, April 6th here in Seoul. Hey everyone, it's Debbie from Korea Now, and these are your daily headlines.
South Korean delegates sent by President-elect Yoon Suk-yeol met with U.S. National Security Advisor Jake Sullivan at the White House on Tuesday and delivered a personal letter for President Biden from Yoon. The chief of Yoon's delegation, Park Jin, said the letter highlights the need to further upgrade the alliance between South Korea and the U.S. in order to tackle North Korea's nuclear issue, while also boosting cooperation on a range of global issues, including climate change and supply chain resiliency. They also discussed the possible deployment of U.S. strategic assets to South Korea amid growing tensions with the North. Strategic assets generally refers to military hardware like nuclear-powered submarines and long-range bombers that are often used as a show of force to deter provocations by potential enemies. The officials also discussed the need to hold a South Korea-U.S. summit at an early stage after Yoon's inauguration next month. The mountain sitting behind Cheongwadae is now fully open to public. The southern part of Mount Bugak had been closed off for security reasons since 1968, when a group of North Korean commandos were on a mission to assassinate then-President Park Chung-hee and hid in the mountain for 2 weeks. The opening was part of President Moon's campaign pledge to return Mount Bugak to the public, but the timing of the opening is interesting as preparations are underway to move the presidential office to Yongsan and open the current Cheongwadae building to the public under President-elect Yoon Suk-yeol's plans. On Wednesday, the cabinet approved 36 billion won in funds for the relocation, a day after President Moon called for a swift approval of the budget. BTS may perform at the inaugural ceremony of South Korea's new President Yoon Suk-yeol next month. That's according to Park Ju-sun, the chief of Yoon's inauguration committee, who said discussions are underway for a possible performance by BTS at the ceremony on May 10th. This comes after Yoon's transition team visited BTS's agency last Saturday to discuss what the new administration can do for startups and entertainment businesses.
And those are your top stories. For full-length articles, you can go to our official website, link down below. As always, make sure to subscribe to Korea Now for more daily updates.